Welcome back to a jubilant Tom Adams Field here on the campus of Wayne State University, where the Wayne State Warriors have pulled the upset, defeating the 25th ranked and previously undefeated Saginaw Valley State Cardinals 24-20. And that's a happy crowd down there, Rod.
It's a happy Coach Winters, and we don't get to see enough of that, but laughing, joking, and rightly so, beat a ranked team at home in the GLIAC opener.
The Warriors came out early, took that opening drive, got a touchdown, actually opened up a 17-0 lead. Then it got a little scary because, hey, these guys weren't undefeated for no reason. That's a good football team they just beat. They made it interesting, and the Warriors, we just talked about it, they made one more play. They made the plays when they had to be made, and it was your seniors, it was your big guys making the plays, the Deontay Nicholas's, Dakota Cups, Leon Eggleston's. They made the plays when you had to have.
Right, and I think, as Coach Winter said, it's the defense. And the defense, much maligned, gave up a lot of points in the first couple of games, as you said, but made plays in the first quarter, certainly, but at the end of the game and getting Saginaw Valley off the field with no points.
We mentioned Eggleston, Brandon Tuck-Hayden, Jalen Lewis, Damani Green.
Yeah.
We could name them all. Myron Riley Brown.
Yeah, there's
another game. One. I mean, he was challenged all night. McDade made plays. Houston made plays. These guys, they all showed up. Smith, we could name them all because they all made plays.
Yep.
Speaking of plays, let's look at some of the highlights. Let's go to the first half, show you that. Warriors got it going on that opening drive, and it was Dakota Cup taking it in from the outside. Dakota Cup's got some legs, man. He ran for 42 yards today and a touchdown.
Right, but it was just the run game on that first drive that set all of that stuff up for them.
Then the first play from scrimmage for the Cardinals offense, they fumble it. Jalen Lewis picks it up, takes it down to the 2-yard line. That turns in to a Salo field goal. That gives the Warriors a 10-0 lead. And before you knew what happened, before they had actually been able to run a play, Saginaw Valley was,
yeah,
they're down 10-0. And then Leon Eggleston.
Yeah, takes the pick there and runs it back. Just a short little 8-9 yard run for him. And it's just redemption for one that he dropped last year. And he said he was going to get the next one, and he got the next one.
Absolutely. Had four tackles today as well and was involved in a whole bunch of other plays on top of that. And how about this throw?
Yeah.
Picked off, coming back. He had an open man. Instead, Woolridge brings it back, and that was where you thought, oh boy, maybe, or Whiteside, I should say, brings it back. You thought, maybe something bad's going to happen here. Lucic made the first of his two field goals in the first half, and that gave Saginaw a little bit of life. You know what gave him a lot of life? 83 yards here by McCrary.
Right, and this is where the game looked to turn when McCrary ran this back for 83 yards. That maybe you thought, hey, this is going to deflate Wayne State coming out of halftime. They had the big lead, and now they're cutting down to four. But the defense didn't need to do much more. Offense responds right here on the next drive, gets a big throw here.
Flea flicker, 40 yards to Potterack. I mean, we talked about it. Get to that tight end. We knew he was going to be a factor all season long, and there he leads the way in for James Hill. Ninth consecutive game with a rushing touchdown. That ties him for the second best streak, or gives him, well, third best streak after Joik Bell's 2-13
yeah,
game streaks. But great job by James Hill today. Conklin then able to take that in. That gets the game closer. And then keep an eye on 97. Boom, blocks that field goal. That was going to cut it to one. That changes everything. It stays a four-point game. Huge play for the Warriors. They're able to run the clock out. Dakota Cup, Deontay Nicholas getting some runs at the end of the game. He finished with 62 yards on 16 carries. By the way, credit where it's due, Nate McCrary, 156 yards on 15 carries. That's where that rushing yards comes from for Saginaw Valley. The Warriors a little more balanced, though. You've got 62 for Nicholas, 42 for Cup, 41 for Hill, King Sanders with 15. First downs, 50. That's a lot of first downs.
But a couple of things on there. The third down conversions, 8 of 18. That kept the chains moving when they needed them to. And those two turnovers for Saginaw Valley, that's an uphill battle that you just have to – you have to be really good to overcome two turnovers that lead to 10 points that put you in that hole. Wayne State's defense stiffened up when it needed to, held them to field goals instead of touchdowns in those last couple of drives. And that's what really it amounted to. You give them field goal attempts, you block one, and you hold – and your offense is able to push this one away for you.
Let's correct one thing. It was 15 first downs, not 50. But that Warrior team, I think they've got their quarterback. It looks like you're going to stick with Dakota Cup now.
Yeah.
If Deontay Nicholas stays healthy and James Hill's going to get healthier,
sure,
you've got that thunder and lightning now, and that's something that teams are going to have to scout against, defend against, and that should open things up for Darius Roberson. It should open things up for the other receivers. And now you've got a tight end, and they haven't been thrown to the tight end in recent years, but Poderak has become a factor.
Right, and Dakota Cup, 10 of 24, the accuracy, the numbers don't show the accuracy, but the passes that he did complete, those 10 were all very makeable passes and situations where they needed a first down, they needed some yardage, and he was able to do that. So give him credit for that, too.
Absolutely, and we're around this program. We see what kind of guys these are. We know what kind of people the coaches are. Mm-hmm. That was true, genuine exhilaration.
Yeah.
When they won this game, because this season did not start off well for the Warriors. They finally got that win last week. That was a win they're supposed to get.
Yeah.
This one shows, okay, we're ready for the GLIAC season. We're not just going to show up and take our beating and go home. We're right. going to play you, and you're going to have to play really well if you want to beat us.
Right, and especially coming off last season, the struggles of last season, going 2-9, to get the second win at home against a ranked team. And I keep saying ranked team. It may not mean a lot. They're number 25, so they're barely ranked. But it sets up the rest of your season that the possibility is still there. You're not deflated coming off of a loss in your opener in the conference schedule, and you can still do something. Next week you got Northern. You might be able to build some momentum for Ferris State when they come in here in a couple of weeks. All of that is still on the table because you won your first conference game.
And we're going to have that Ferris State game for you right here live on CN900 in a couple of weeks after the Warriors go up north to play Northern Michigan next week. For my partner Rod Beard, for Tony Ortiz, for our director Mike Johnson, for our entire hard-working crew here at CN900, I'm Joe Abramson. Thanks for looking in. Again, the final score, the Wayne State Warriors 24, Saginaw Valley 20. You've been watching Wayne State football right here on CN900.